The back wheels with the actual like rubber tires are connected to the two large motors. We have a large motor for the forklift to move up and down, and we decided to keep on a medium motor so we could spin this and we could pick up the reverse engineer.
Okay, so how are you gonna spin that? What spins?
We have an attachment
over here. It's like right here has.
There are two things sticking out from this.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Gotcha.
Okay.
So the attachment turns.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. So how many attachments do you have that you need to put on it? Are you going to be taking some off and putting others on during the mission?
Yes.
Okay.
So
how many are there?
So then we're going to do...
Well, this one is only one attachment.
Yeah, we have one for push down this and to.
No, we only have
combined.
One.
Yeah, it's combined.
It's one that's combined.
And it does these two missions.
Okay.
And for this one, we're going to have something on the side to push this.
It like goes right into the hole and it pushes it 90 degrees.
Oh, okay.
Something over here to spin it. And then a fork.
So to do the different tasks, do you have to change the attachments?
Yeah. Yes.
So you have to bring it all the way back here, change the attachments, and then
and
send it back up?
Missions.
Excuse me?
Once we finish the missions, we head back to base to change that.
Okay.
So who did the programming?
All of us.
All of
you? Okay. Do you have an example of the programming for any of the missions?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
This is an example of our master program. Like, there's different buttons on like the robot.
Each mission has
these different ones, and
so that we
after we click the master program, we can click either one, any one of these buttons, and what runs the program.
Okay.
Instead of selecting the program by itself.
Oh, okay. Oh, so that's what the master program does?
Yeah.
It just allows you to push one button and it starts up.
Yeah, and we have like a bunch of blocks to do each mission.
Okay.
The block is we create a program, and when we finish with it, we turn it into a block so that the program is all in that block, so we can press any of the buttons, and that block will run.
Okay.
It's an easier way to store the programs we make instead of having a really long.
Can you show us an example of one of the missions?
Yeah, this is a wine cooler. Yeah. It backs up so that it can.
Okay. So what's going on there?
It's returning,
it.
So we don't have to touch
it's
it.
It's following the line polymer, so that the path can go back to base.
Okay.
And then it comes up.
Wow. Very cool. Very cool. Cool. Well, it looks like a great robot.
Thank you.
Think it's going to do really well. I think we're out of time for this session, but thank you for showing it to us. And good luck.
Yes, good luck.
Thank
very nice.
You.
Thank you.
Just let us know when you're ready.
Alright. Good afternoon, judges. Our team name is Courreges Lego Builders, and our team number is 3473.
Here, the first column column is ice cream, and the fourth column is candy. Can one of you tell me which is the most popular?
I know. The first column is cookie, which is 10 units high, which means 10 students voted for cookie. Therefore, cookie is the most popular.
Isn't learning with the portable CTS learning opinion much easier?
Yeah! Learning with the portable CTS learning companion is fun, fun, fun!
Yes, so what are you going to do is you're going to choose one member of your team to get blindfolded. That member is the only one that's allowed to touch the pieces. Okay? The rest of the team has to give instructions to the member on how to put the puzzle together. You can't touch the blindfolded person and you can't touch the pieces, right? What you can do is look at the picture.
And you can tell them instructions or you can't move their hands.
You can't move their hands. They have to be blindfolded and they're the ones that are going to touch the pieces, reach out and put everything together. All right, and your time starts now, so you guys have to choose.
Okay, here we go.
I'd rather it's cool.
Looks like the door is open on table three.
Oh, another high score.
Apprenticeship on table two. Search engine has been activated on table one. Apprenticeship model being pushed out. Oh.
Open.
We have a loop on project-based learning on table number four. As well as I think there are apprenticeship models out there as well. We have table number four. Looks like they're using their senses to retrieve the loop off of the board.
Got
they have used their senses on the table.
Got it! Oh, yeah! Did it? Oh!
Table one looking to deliver a loop. Oh, it's caught up on the door. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Stop those robots! All right. So if we call your team name and team number, you're going to jump up. You're going to cheat them. You're going to run to the back toward your parents. But you're not going to stop there. You're going to come around this way. And you're going to run. And I'm not running today because I'm tired. But you're going to come all the way around here. And then you're going to start right here, and you're going to give a high five to every single judge. And then Kayla is going to hand you your trophy. And then you're going to come over here in front of these two tables here, where parents, you can take their picture. Take their picture and then head back to your seats. Okay? You got that? Okay. Team members, turn around for a second. Give a round of applause to your parents who brought you here today. To your coaches and mentors who got you this far. And finally, give yourself a round of applause for participating in today's event. On to what you've been waiting for. I'd like to welcome Molly to the podium to announce this year's Judges Awards.
Hello, everyone. All right, so many of the high quality teams do not fit the mold for an existing award, but nonetheless deserve one. Some teams have a story that profoundly sets them apart in a unique way, and sometimes a given award is so close that the judges want to recognize them for their team's achievement. This award gives the judges the freedom to recognize the most remarkable team for which a standard award does not exist. So, first up, one of this year's judges' awards goes to Team 8449 RoboCops. Pictures, our second judges award this year goes to team 3473, Courreges Robot.
Thank you.